People and welcome. We will see here how to use Sony Soundforge Pro 11 in very few and easy steps. Please leave comments if you find mistakes in pronunciation. Soundforge Pro is a simple program used to edit and manage sound easily without going into deep in audio production. With this software you can manage single soundtracks per time. You may need a more complex software to make professional audio projects with multi-tracks. Let's have a general overview. The workspace is composed by four main parts. On top you have the main bar, where you find all the options the software has, the quick buttons of the toolbar to manage and edit fast, the meters on the right, they show the intensity of the sound in output, and the rest is your workspace, where you will open and close windows in general. To import a track, simply drag the sound file into your workspace. It will appear a window showing the waveform of such file in full. If you need to open a new project, go to File and then to New instead. These windows are managed normally. You can move, close, or minimize them. Windows minimized are put in the bottom left corner, whereas a maximized one can be ruled using the buttons in the top right corner. Let's go into deep. Each window opened is a Soundforge project that contains one or more samples that can never be played at the same time, but just be overlapped. You can see here two different parts. On top you have a full description of the whole waveform that characterizes your project, and more at the bottom, where you are going to work and edit the sample imported. You can zoom horizontally using your mouse wheel, and vertically holding Ctrl down and using your mouse wheel to see better the waveform peaks. As you zoom, the upper waveform shows you where you are looking at. Click on and drag to move through the sample waveform. Expand the edges to set the zoom. At the bottom you have two different region markers. These keep the beginning and the end points of a part or the whole waveform for different purposes. At the bottom left corner you have the player. You have two different play buttons. Play normal means playing the waveform and stopping when it finishes. This can be done fast using your keyboard. Press space to play normal and press it again to stop. Clicking at an instant sets the position of the playhead, indicated through a black and thin bar. When you play normal, the player starts from there. Play as sample plays the waveform, considering also the light blue region marker, called the sustaining loop. When the player enters this region, the track is continuously being played in the whole part that is inside this region. The timeline is indicated in hours, minutes and seconds by default. You can personalize it, going to Options and then to Status Format. The other options lets you set other properties as well. Below you have the rate bar. This is used to set the playing speed. A rate equal to 1 means normal speed. You will accelerate if you put a rate higher than 1, otherwise you will play the track slower. A negative rate plays the track on the other way. The gray arrows work as long as you hold them. You need to move the little orange triangle to fix the speed at a certain rate. Let's edit the track. There are different edit tools you can use, and all of them can be found in the list of quick buttons more on the right. You can browse them clicking beside the lock icon. The edit tool is used to edit the track as you wish. Click to fix the playhead. Click and drag to fix the loop region, the second region marker we haven't seen yet. This sets the part of the track that is selected and is indicated under a black background. Click and drag to move it. Drag the edges to change its length. As you can see, there are more than a single waveform shown. These are called channels and can be 1, 2 or even 6. This is a 2-channel track, so it is stereo, having a left channel, the one indicated as 1, and a right channel, the number 2. Use the smaller blue icon to reduce or show a waveform in full. You can select either a single channel or all of them. If you click and drag right below the sustaining loop region, you will create a loop region that selects all the channels of the track. If you do the same on a particular channel, you will select just that channel. If you change mind, you can click on the left to select or deselect channels. If you right click on the selected part, you can cut it to delete the part. You can paste fixing the playhead first and then right clicking. The pasted waveform will be put right after the playhead. The next button is called Magnify tool and is a zoom tool. Click and drag to zoom a particular part of the waveform. Click once to zoom out in full. The event tool lets you edit the tracks much faster, but without being precise as much as the edit tool. As a single event is intended a compact piece of waveform in your track. At first your track is compact, so a unique event describes it in full. When you start editing it, it won't be compact anymore, so the event tool can be pretty useful in case you want to manage the single blocks instead of the waveform as it is. Click on the waveform to select it in full and fix the playhead. An event selected is indicated in blue color. If you press S, you will split the waveform into 2 different events that you can select and locate just with the event tool. Each event starts with a small yellow corner. You can click on an event to select it and drag it to move it throughout the track. If events get overlapped, a crossfade is created, so then you can pass from the first event to the second one in a smooth way. Right-click and go to Fade Type to change the kind of crossfade. Moreover, you can drag the edges to shorten or extend the event. Drag from the yellow corner to set a single side crossfade. You can set its type right-clicking on it. Approach the upper side of an event and pull it up or down to set its gain, eventually in case you want the event to be less loud. Right-click on an event to cut, copy or paste it as usual. What to do if you mistake? You can simply undo using the left curved arrow, pressing Ctrl and Z, or going to View and then opening the Undo Redo History window. Then, if you want to fix instance of time or parts of the waveform, you can use the markers. Simply right-click to insert them. You can further analyze the frequency spectrum of your track. Go to View and then to Spectrum Analysis. This shows you the track's intensity in decibels, vertically, versus the frequency band, measured in Hertz. Enable the real-time monitoring to update the spectrum live. Let's see how to edit this track. While in edit mode, right-click to find the envelopes. The envelope is a line that sets the value of a property during time. The face of the envelope are revealed if you play normal, but not if you play a sample. The pen envelope sets the panning in time, so which channel has to be louder. The volume envelope sets how the track volume has to be in time. Pull the line up or down to set the correct value. Double click to fix a point in an instant of time. Multiple points can help you to evolve the envelope line. Right-click on the points to change the kind of line between two points, or simply delete the point interested. If you don't see the envelope line on your track, click on Bypass in the plugin chain window. If you don't find windows, remember to tick them from the View section. This window lists the envelopes applied and any of the plugin effects that you can add clicking on Add Plugins to Chain. Remove the effect added, right-clicking and going to Remove. Use Show Plugin window to manage the effect in full in a second window. Let's see quickly the effects. Select the part of the waveform where you want any effect to be applied. Just that area will be affected. If you don't select any part, the effect will be applied on the whole track of the project. There are two kinds of effects, the ones used to improve the quality of the track and the ones that do change the track and its kind. All of these are distributed between the process and effects sections. You can distort, reverse the waveform or the peaks, and so on. Try them out. To improve sound quality, you can use the EQ equalizer, the DC offset, and all the four options you can find in between of the tools window. Even if SoundForge is not a software to make videos, you can still attach frames to your track. Simply go to File and then to Attach Video to browse for your video. This will be added in the window selected at the moment. You can't edit or modify the video in any way. If you need to go pro, Sony Vegas Pro may be the best software for you. Last thing to know is how to save. Go to File and then to Save As, to save your project selected in your workspace. In this way you will save your whole project as .frg in order to edit it in the future. The project is saved with a folder with its same name, used to save copies of the source files used. Without these, the project can't work properly in the future. Whereas, if you need to render the track just built or edited, just go to File and then to Render As. Select where to render it and in which kind of audio format. If your track has video frames attached, make sure to select a video format instead. Remember that you need to save your project first, or you won't be able to render your track. Thanks for watching this video. Check our channel to discover other nice and professional softwares.